Hi there! Welcome back to GeeklyEDU! In this video, we are going to talk about the chain rule, one of the most important rules in calculus. This is because with this rule, we can derivate many functions we can't with the basic rules we studied in previous videos. Let's see this function. The terms inside the parentheses can be manipulated with algebra to get the derivative. But then, what happens with the cubic term? We can rewrite this function with a change of variables like follow, and u is a function of x that we will denote g of x. Therefore, the original function is a function of f of g of x. That is called a composite function. And to derivate this type of functions, we are going to use the chain rule. For a composite function like the one we saw before in the form f of x equal to f of g of x, being g and f both differentiable functions, the derivative using the chain rule is the derivative of the function f evaluated in g of x and multiplied by the derivative of g of x. Or in other terms, being a function y equal to f of u and u is a function equal to g of x, the derivative of the function y in x is the derivative of y in u multiplied by the derivative of u in x. This is the same rule but with different notation. Using the chain rule, we are going to calculate the derivative of the function discussed at the beginning of this video. Rewriting this function by defining a new function u, we can use the formula of the derivative of the function. Substituting these terms, we can solve this derivative separately. First, the derivative of y equal to u cubic. This derivative is simple using the rule of the derivative of a power, and the result is 2 times u squared. We have to substitute this u with the original terms of u. And now we have to calculate the second derivative using the quotient rule and simplifying. Now we have to multiply these two terms and simplify this product, and we got our final answer. Let's solve one more example. In this case, we have to derivate a function using more than once the chain rule. When we have this kind of functions, we have to operate from the outside to the inside. This means first the powers and roots, and then what is inside of the parentheses. First, we are going to identify the function u and rewrite the y function with the change of variable. Using the chain rule, we substitute those terms. The first derivative is solved by using the power rule, and then we have to substitute the expression equal to u. Let's solve the second derivative. This is done with the addition rule, and instead of one derivative, we have the addition of two derivatives. The first one is equal to 1, and the second is again a composite function. Using the chain rule, we define y equal to u cubic and u equal to x plus sine of x. Substituting these terms in the chain rule, we have the product of two derivatives. the derivative of u cubic is 3 times u squared. Again, we substitute the value of u. Now, we have to obtain the second derivative of the product. In this case, we have an addition, and therefore we are going to use the addition rule. Being the derivative of x equal to 1, and the derivative of sine of x equal to cosine of x, and finally, we have to put all these expressions together, and we got our final result.
Try to solve this problem and leave your answer in the comments below.
Cannot find a topic you're struggling with? Tell us in the comments section and subscribe to make sure you're first to know when we cover it.